वनकम, मैं हैदर अली सैयद आशीर्वाद से यूनाइटेड अंडर तमिल सेवा। कुरान चैप्टर 49 वर्स 13 सेज टू आइडेंटिफाई बाय रेस एंड ट्राइब। हु आर द मुस्लिम वर्ल्ड बाय रेस एंड ट्राइब? हु आर दे बाय डीएनए? व्हेन आई से मुस्लिम वर्ल्ड आई मीन कंट्रीज फ्रॉम टर्की, अरेबिया टू इंडस वैली। इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट आर्यन सेटलर्स, रोमन, पर्शियन, who occupying land from Turkey to Indus Valley, Arabia, including Jammu Kashmir. Remember, those Aryan settlers, Roman Persian, have occupied land of the natives, the Black Tamil and the Semitic Black race. Remember, Mahabharat war, which wiped out Tamil Shiva Pandyan dynasty from Turkey to Indus Valley, Gujarat, Rajasthan, thus making an easy migration of Aryans at Indus Valley without any resistance from the black natives. Now we are going to discuss about Aryan settlers, Roman Persian, who occupying land from Turkey to Indus Valley, Arabia, including Jammu Kashmir. Remember, those Aryan settlers, Roman Persian, have occupied land of the natives, the Black Tamil and the Semitic Black race. Remember, Mahabharat war, which wiped out Tamil Shiva Pandyan dynasty from Turkey to Indus Valley, Gujarat, Rajasthan, thus making an easy migration of Aryans at Indus Valley without any resistance from native black. Remember, it was Persian Aryan settlers who came and introduced principles of Varnadharam, Manu Sastra and Brahmanism. They further introduced Vaishnav cult. Later, different mythology and the Shivaite and Vaishnav cult was introduced. Koil was once a house of a king, which converted into Aryan Brahmin avatar idol's temple. Remember, Sanskrit was only an oral language. It was Tamil scholars who gave Sanskrit a written form. All the work of Tamil books were translated into Sanskrit and later those Tamil books were destroyed, thus making Aryan Brahmin alone knower of Vedas. Semitic black race lived under the administration of Tamil Shiva Pandyan dynasty. After Mahabharat war, Tamil Shiva Pandyan dynasty wiped out. As Pandyan dynasty collapsed after Mahabharat war, children of Israel of Semitic black race had no king to protect them from Persian Aryan settlers who under Philistine Goliath attacked children of Israel. Ark of Covenant, which united the 12 tribes of children of Israel, and Saul was appointed as the first king of Black Hebrew. David killed Goliath. Later, seed of David occupied the position of royal bloodline and they had the authority, in other words, rights to administer children of Israel and other tribes of Semitic black race. Solomon, son of David, built their first administration center at Jerusalem called Masjid-e-Aqsa or Temple of Solomon. Koel means house of a king. Similarly, Temple of Solomon was a parliament where Ark of Covenant was kept. Remember, the unity among 12 tribes of House of Israel was due to the Ark of Covenant. The Persian Empire at the time of Prophet Muhammad. Remember, people who responded to Prophet Muhammad were Tamil King, Children of Israel and other black tribes. Tamil King saw the splitting of the moon and then checked the holy books and later confirmed that final messenger has arrived. Tamil king traveled to Arabia to meet Prophet Muhammad. Later at Kerala, Asivagam Center for Meditation and Yoga was constructed under the name of Cheraman Juma Mosque in Thrissur district in the state of Kerala in the year 629 AD. Quran talks about splitting of moon in chapter 54 verse 1 and 2. I read, the hour is near and the moon is cleft asunder. But if they see a sign, they turn away and say, this is but transit magic. Many ancient traditions in China, Maya, India, witness talks about the event splitting of moon. But when the curse heedless people, Aryan settlers, saw the event, they said, it's a magic. People who rejected Prophet Muhammad were Aryan settlers, Roman Persian. They rejected the invitation of Prophet Muhammad. Bible says that Jesus, a messenger for lost sheep of house of Israel, of Semitic black race. Jesus' mission was not for Gentiles. Gentiles refers to Roman settlers who are from genealogy of Cain. Bible further says that next prophet or comforter who would entertain the Gentiles, the Aryan settlers, Roman and Persian. Please refer Bible prophecy regarding coming of the comforter who would also teach the Gentile as he is the universal messenger. The final messenger, Prophet Muhammad, who is a universal messenger, he was stopped from wasting time on cursed, heedless people whose forefathers had no warner, referring to Gentiles, Roman, Persian, Aryan settlers, who now hides behind Muslim label. Quran chapter 36, 1-11, I read, Yasin, by the wise Quran, indeed you, O Muhammad, are from the among the messengers, on the straight path, a revelation of exalted in might and the merciful, that you may warn a people whose forefathers were not warned, so they are unaware. This verse of Quran, chapter 36, verse 6, talks about the Roman, Persian, Aryan settlers who came from a nation who were barbaric by nature, as they had no warner, as Aryans are children of Cain, the murderer, a generation of incest. Remember, all prophets are of noble birth. I read further, Quran chapter 36, verse 7. I read, already the word has come into effect upon most of them, so they do not believe. Here Quran talks about Persian Aryan settlers who very well know the truth. Remember, it was Persian Aryans who introduced Varna Dharam and other policy to suppress Asivagam principle. Quran chapter 36 verse 8, I read, indeed, we have put shackles on their necks and they are to their chins, so they are with head aloft. This verse talks about the nature of Persian Aryan settlers who now hide behind Muslim label. Aryan settlers are living in a superiority complex like Lucifer, a rebel by nature. Further, Quran says in chapter 36 verse 9, and we have put before them a barrier and behind them a barrier and covered them so they do not see. And it is all the same for them, whether you warn them or do not warn them, they will not believe. You can only warn one who follows the reminder and fear the most merciful, unseen. So give him good tidings of forgiveness and noble reward. Remember, Quran is a reminder for previous scriptures and revelation. How can Quran be a reminder for people who had no warner or books? Quran reminds the way of life which was taught by pen by Almighty, giving to first Siddha, whose religion is called Asivagam. Remember, the final fight was between black native army led by Prophet Muhammad versus the Roman, Persian, Aryan settlers. Quran chapter 9 talks about the war in which settlers lost. Asylum given to Aryan settlers, and further, those Aryan settlers were not allowed to enter Hijaz region of Arabia. I read Quran chapter 9 verse 5, and when the sacred months have passed, then kill the polytheists wherever you find them, and capture them and besiege them, and sit in wait for them at every place of ambush. But if they should repent, establish prayer and give zakat, let them on their way. Indeed, Allah is forgiving and merciful. And if any one of the polytheists seeks your protection, then grant him protection so that he may hear the word of Allah. Then deliver him to his place of safety. This is because they are the people who do not know. Because they are the settlers, who people who do not know, as they are heedless. Further, Quran says in Quran chapter 9 verse 17, it is not for the polytheists to maintain the mosque of Allah, witnessing against themselves with disbelief. Those, their deeds have become worthless, and in the fire they will abide eternally. Remember, Tamil nation and Semitic black race are not idol worshippers. It was pagan Aryan settlers who are polytheists, and they have no right authority over maintenance of Qibla or Kaaba or Koel. Remember, when Quran says pagan or idol worshippers, it does not refer to natives of India, but it refers to Aryan settler Roman Persian who brought paganism with them, who now hides behind Muslim label. Remember, under Asivagam, yoga, meditation and activation of Kundalini chakras and connecting to higher conscious was the mode of worship. For activation of Kundalini chakra, one does not need any priestly cult. Koil means House of Elected Kings, in other words, a parliament. Remember, it was Aryan settlers who introduced paganism into Asivagam on Tamil nation. Persian policy of Varna Dharam, Manu and Brahmanism was taken over by Roman Catholic as religion. Trimurti became Trinity. Manu law was called Hellenistic law. Like Brahmanism, Roman Catholic priest, Pope became door to salvation. Fateh Makkah, victory of Makkah. After the victory, Aryan settlers were not allowed to enter Hijaz region of Arabia. During Prophet Muhammad's time, Mecca became the new administration center for seed of David of children of Israel from the Semitic black race. From 7th century to 15th century, seed of David under the Moors began their administration from Mecca. Moors ruled Spain for 800 years. Beware of Aryan settlers, Roman Persian and their version of fake Islam, which protects Kali Yuga principle of Varna Dharam and Manu. Remember, Jesus never entertained Gentiles, Aryan settlers, Roman Persian, who are now hiding behind Muslim label. Children of Cain has no authority to hijack black prophets and start a religion in their name. Aryan Persian settlers running their policies of Varna Dharam, Manu and Brahmanism under different religion label, under different black prophet's name. It is very clear that Quran stops Prophet Muhammad from entertaining Aryan settlers. Remember, after Prophet Muhammad dead, later Persian killed Hazrat Hussain, the grandson of Prophet Muhammad. Persian, who are the founder of Kali Yuga, they started their conspiracy to end Quran, which is the final reminder for Asivagam. In 8th century, Persian Aryan started Shia cult. In 9th century, Sunni cult was introduced. In 13th century, Sufism cult was started, and in 18th century, Wahhabism cult was introduced. In 19th century, Saudi and Aryan settler illegally occupied Mecca. Remember, Aryans not allowed to enter Hijaz region of Arabia. Remember, Muslim world occupying the land from Turkey, Hijaz region of Arabia to Indus Valley, including Jammu Kashmir, they are Aryan settlers, Roman Persian by DNA, who now hiding behind Muslim label. All Muslim organizations in India are designed to protect Aryan settler policy, thus helping Brahmanism to complete Aryavarta agenda. Backbone of Aryavarta, Hindutva, Brahmanism are the Muslim organizations who are slave of Aryan settler Roman Persian now hiding behind Muslim label. Wahhabism, the army of Aryan settlers protecting Kali Yuga and Brahmanism. Tablighi, Wahhabism, beware of these most deceptive cult on earth. The art of destroying the truth is well mastered by Persian Aryans. Role of different cult of Persian Aryan settler are as follows. Shia Sufi introduced Farsi Urdu language, which comes under Indo-European Aryan language in Madarsa, thus making Arabic the language of as classical. There is a saying, if one has to destroy the truth, then all one has to do is first destroy the language. Remember, every Muslim in India, Pakistan, Bangladesh, Sri Lanka reads Quran, but they don't understand what they are reading. The art of destroying truth and keeping Kali Yuga alive is well mastered by Persian Aryan. In India, there are more than 2 lakh madrasas runs in the name of Quran, but Arabic language is under classical. Coming to Sufi cult, Sufism is nothing but they following Brahmanism system, which says that door to salvation, moksha, is through a Brahmin. Similarly, Sufi cult following Piri Muridi system, which says, without Peer, one cannot enter heaven. The role of Tabligh Jamaat is to establish Shat Namaj, which is based on Burak Hadith. Remember, that Burak Hadith goes against Quran. Another role of Tabligh Jamaat is to substitute Quran and replace Quran with their book called Fazail-e-Amal. Remember, art of destroying truth is well mastered by Aryan settlers, Roman Persian, who now hides behind Muslim label. Rise of Saudi Wahhabi. Main role of Wahhabism, Ahle Hadith, Salafi, comparative religion is to create new market for Hajj, Umrah, benefiting Aryan Saudi who illegally occupying Mecca. Basically, a Wahhabi organization is a terrorist outfit. They are protector of final antichrist Aryan Saudi. Beware of Saudi funded organization across globe as they have sold their soul to Satan. Follow the instruction of Quran chapter 49 verse 13. Identify by race and tribe. If you start seeing by race and tribe, one will find that Muslim world by DNA are Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, whom Bible calls children of swine, and Quran chapter 36 1 to 11 stops Prophet Muhammad from wasting time on cursed heedless people whose forefathers had no honor. The final antichrist is Saudi Kingdom, who does not want to establish the Kingdom of God. Kingdom of God can come only through Asivagam, whose main enemies are Aryan settlers, Roman, Persian, now hiding behind Muslim label. Aryavarta, a Muslim world agenda. Bible, Isaiah chapter 11 verse 12 says, while Quran chapter 17 verse 104 confirms about the final exodus, God promised that one day He would gather His children from the four corners of the earth and bring them back home to the land of Israel. In Bible, Isaiah 11 verse 12 says, I read, and He will set up an ensign for the nation and will assemble the dispersed of Israel and gather together the scattered of Judah from the four corners of the earth. Similarly, Quran confirms Bible in chapter 17 verse 104, I read, and we said after Pharaoh to the children of Israel, dwell in the land, and when there comes the promise of hereafter, we will bring you forth in one gathering. Children of Israel, of Semitic black race, tribe Judah, the seed of David, to return home, taking back their old administration center at Jerusalem from fake white Jew disguised as chosen people, who in reality are from the genealogy of Cain. Similarly, children of Israel, of Semitic black race, tribe Judah, seed of David, in their final exodus, will also take back their new administration center at Mecca, which is currently illegally occupied by Aryan settler Saudi, the devil from Najd, who disguise himself as Arabs. Real Arabs are black. We are in end time. Doomsday for final antichrist, Aryan settler Saudi. What is Asivagam? Asivagam is the way of life followed by all prophets from Tamil Shiva allies Seth, Noah, Ibrahim, Moses, Jesus, and Muhammad.
Welcome. Thank you.